This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is part two of learning the basics of the rate time distance formula. So it's pretty basic, and we're going to be working with this formula, rate times time equals distance. So in part one, we said, well, if we've got the rate in miles per hour, I need to be consistent that if it's per hour, that my time has to also be in hours. So this is a little bit different. It says, if you are traveling 50 miles per hour for 30 minutes, how far have you gone? Well, you can imagine if you went an hour, right, you would go 50 miles. Does that make sense? Because you're going 50 miles in 1 hour. But if you're only going half an hour, you're only going to go halfway. So it makes sense you would only go 25 miles, right? So it makes sense that the answer here should be 25 miles, hopefully. But how could you use the formula, rate times time equals distance, to get that 25 miles? So you've got a rate of 50 miles per hour. Or you could write that as 50 miles over 1 hour. And the time is the tricky part here. You've got 30 minutes. If this is in hours, you can't keep your time in minutes. You're going to have to change that to hours. And the trick is, how do you write 30 minutes in terms of an hour? Now, most people know that's half an hour. So that's fine. If you already know that, you could just say, well, oh, that's half an hour. And you're good to go here. We could use the formula. But the distance we're looking for is the rate times time, which of course will give you a rate, 50. Now we know that they're both in hours. We don't have to write all this stuff out. 50 times 1/2, and we know the answer is going to be in miles because it was miles per hour. So that's one way to get the 25 miles for answer. But what if you don't know it's half an hour? Right, so if you're not sure it's half an hour, here's another way of getting it. You might want to look at my videos on unit conversions. 30 minutes. How do I change 30 minutes to an hour? I have to think how hours and minutes are related. And I know that 1 hour equals 60 minutes, right? So what you could do is think of this as the fraction, 30 minutes over 1. And say, I want to get this in terms of hours. Since these are the same number, I'm going to multiply it by the fraction where the minutes are going to cancel. So I'm going to put 60 minutes in the denominator is the same as 1 hour in the numerator. This is like multiplying by the number 1. And you could cancel 30 and 60. And notice you are going to get 1/2 hour. So if you weren't sure how to change it to 1/2 hour, that's one way of doing it. And then you could proceed and get 25 miles. All right, so it's important to be careful that your time is consistent, right? Hours and hours or minutes and minutes. All right, so here are two problems for you to try. Find the distance traveled for a car traveling at the given rate for the time listed. So see if you could do these on your own. Did you put the video on pause and try it? Okay, so we're going to use the formula distance equals rate times time. Now I notice I've got miles per hour and the time's in hours. So all I have to do is multiply these numbers together. And since I've got all the right units here, I don't have to worry about writing everything out and canceling. I could simply say the distance is 22 times 1 1/2. Now, you could write 1.5, you could write 1 1/2. I'm going to write 1 1/2 as 3/2. And then my answer will be what? I'm talking about my distance. That will be, I'm going to use the miles here. So my answer will be in miles. So now I just want to simplify that. 2 goes into 22, 11. So my answer will be 33 miles. So that's how far you'd go. And that makes sense, doesn't it? If you're going 22 miles per hour, so in 1 hour, you'd go 22 miles, and then the next half hour, you would go 11. That does add up to 33. All right, what about this one? We've got a rate of 60 miles per hour, but our time is given in minutes. This is a problem. I've got my rate in hours and my time in minutes. So I need to alter these minutes so I have it in terms of hours. Now, I'm sure that some of you know what that is. 15 minutes, what part of an hour is that? It's actually 1/4 hour. It's a quarter of an hour. But if you didn't know that, what you could do is, I'm going to just put MIN so I have a little more room here, is I could say, well, I need to change that to hours. So I'm going to use the conversion factor, minutes and hours. What's their relationship? I know that I want hours, my answer to be in hours, so I know that 1 hour is the same as 60 minutes. So therefore, if I cancel here, I would get 1/4 hour, which most people already know that 15 minutes is a fourth of the hour, looking at a clock. So now I could do my distance. Now that I've got it matching my hours and my hours, everything's matching up, I could not worry about all that. And I know my answer will be again in miles because it's miles per hour. So I have my rate, right, times my time, which was 1/4. And let's see. I forgot to put miles. My answer is going to be in miles, right? That's going to be 15. So my answer would be 15 miles. Now you might say, oh, could I just always put what that number is? No, that just so happens because I had you going at 60 miles an hour. If you were going, 100 miles an hour, you would have 100 times 1/4, and of course you get 25 miles. It'd be different. So you still have to figure out what that is part of the hour and do rate times time equaling your distance. Okay, on the next video, we'll do some problems where we don't know the rate or we don't know the time. So we're going to get be given either the distance and the rate, which means we'll figure out the time, or we'll be given the distance and the time and we'll have to figure out the rate. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.